New at 9, do you ever wonder what happens to the things confiscated by the TSA? We found out many of the items are ending up for sale online as part of a new initiative by the state, but where does the money earned from your old or sometimes new stuff go? It's your money, so we went to find out.
Okay, here.
What is that?
Golfing.
Yep, someone tried to carry on these golf clubs. That doesn't happen often, but what does happen weekly, people bringing Swiss Army knives, tools.
And plenty box cutter too.
It's incredible how many items people have had to fork over to the TSA at Hawaii's airports.
You see?
Or in some cases, accidentally leave behind. And most of the items end up here at the state surplus property office in Mapunapuna.
Weekly, we go to Honolulu Airport to collect that. And for the neighbor island, they send it to us every quarter.
In the past, the items would just sit in this warehouse, waiting to be purchased by other state agencies or nonprofits. But 3 months ago, the state procurement office decided to allow the public to buy them through an online auction.
And the auction period is 1 week. We start Monday, we finish Monday. And the person that bought the item have to pay within 3 days and pick up the item within 3 weeks.
And you need to pick up the items you win in person. They won't mail you the items.
Yeah.
If they're on the neighbor island, they gotta have family or friends come.
Yeah, they can authorize person to come pick it up.
Other people's loss can be your gain.
This is bottle opener, starting with $20.
For the whole lot, for
yes.
50 of them?
Yes.
What a great deal.
Yeah.
And brand new too.
Yeah, bottle opener.
Or how about these tools?
30 pieces of it, the miscellaneous tools. It's about $20 starting bit.
As for the two golf clubs plus the pool stick, they're up for auction right now as part of one lot. Opening bid, $40. The money raised from the weekly auction helps fund the surplus property office for salaries, accounting, and other expenses.
No state taxpayer dollars are used to pay for this.
No, no. We all run our self-sufficient.
Perhaps this is also a lesson learned. Make sure you know what you can and can't bring onto the plane.
Once the TSA collect the item through the carry-on bag, they cannot get it back. That's it, they cannot get it back. Once they drop in the box, that's not theirs no more.
You could bid on it and get your stuff back.
Absolutely, yes, absolutely, yes.
Obviously, not the best way to go about it. You don't want to have to buy it again. But obviously, you can get a really good deal if you go on that website. And we do have a link to that surplus auction on our website, kh12.com. Now, we also have a link to the TSA's website, so you can check out the list of items not allowed on the plane.
Good idea.
Know before you go on that next trip.
If you have 20, 30 nieces or nephews, and you want to give them all a little Swiss Army knife, bingo.
Yeah, you can
buy the whole lot.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Coming up.